day, another adventure with your homeboy Jermaine, and getting this vlog started off on the tube, or I don't know if this is a tube, this looks more like a train.
Welcome aboard the Southern Service to West Croydon. The next station is Battersea Park.
Leaving central London, I'm gonna go explore some other areas outside of like the, you know, city center, outside of where all the action is. More local neighborhoods, more of those like low-key neighborhoods, those neighborhoods that I don't really go to, but the spots that I really love. So that's pretty much what I got going on in this vlog right now. I just got on the train now, and what a wild fiasco getting to the train station. I was walking to Victoria Station. I thought I was like, you know, in the area of Victoria Station, so I went to the Starbucks, walked out of that Starbucks, walked the other way, and come to find out, I wasn't in the Victoria Station area at all. The Starbucks I went to was like a mile from the Victoria Station, and then when I got out of that Starbucks, I was walking like that way, and I thought for sure like I would walk like maybe 2 or 3 minutes and I would hit Victoria Station. No, I walked like 10 minutes in the other direction. And anyway, to make a long story short, I finally got here, finally arrived. I, you know, jumped on one of those city bikes, jumped on one of those little bikes and rode off to Victoria Station. Now I'm on the train, about to go explore another area of London, yo. And let's get this video started. As of now, I'm in the Brixton neighborhood. Is that correct? Did I say it wrong?
Brixton Hill.
Leading to Brixton Hill, because I always butcher names like crazy when I'm out traveling and backpacking. Where are you gonna take me to now? There's
the prison.
You're gonna take me to a prison?
Yep.
So. Is that exactly where I wanna go?
Yeah. I booked you a room.
you booked me a room to the prison. How much is it a night? I'm just curious.
Oh, it's free.
It's free.
It's that Majesty's pleasure.
Oh, gosh.
You're very welcome.
If it's free, it can't be good, yo. Can't be good. Yeah, why are these hairstyles around here?
Yeah, it's awesome stuff.
The city center or the...
We are headed into Brixton town centre now.
So. I wonder, what's the American version? Because I know in Europe they always say city centre, but in the US I guess we don't really have city centres.
I think we do call them both. We call them a lot. Yeah, some people would say in the city centre, but more likely you've got a town in the, this is the city of London, and then you've got little
towns.
Little towns. So we, the signposts will mainly say town center. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, so it's kind of like you have New York City, but then you have Brooklyn, which is still in New York City.
Yeah.
But Brooklyn is sort of the neighborhood and the town within New York.
That's right. That's the one.
Because these cities are so freaking big, they need another little city inside so people can figure out where they are.
That's the one.
Big places.
You know that. So.
Oh, check out these buildings here. Look at this older building on the top, and then look at this older building.
Yeah.
And then look down below. They, of course, they did some remodeling here.
Where's Tyler?
Oh wow, it's busy around here.
I do like an ambulance.
So I guess this is where they had all the black folks at in London. I'm definitely seeing a lot more color around here. It kind of reminds me of South Memphis.
And there's
not literally.
You know that there's a road around here called Electric Avenue, and a lot of people, you can Google it up. There's a song by Eddie Grant called Electric Avenue.
That's the famous street. I've definitely heard of that.
Which is basically up there. You can see the sign above Iceland. Can you see it up there?
Oh, Iceland. Oh, Electric Avenue. This is Electric Avenue.
This is Electric.
Is this where you want to go?
Yeah, we can go down here. So
a quick little stroll.
Yeah, the Mad Market.
Wow, this is cool.
Yeah, it's cool.
Elliot, off there.
Noticing prices are a whole lot cheaper around here versus you know, central London and the places that I was at, you know.
Massive difference. Massive difference on the prices.
Like what, like 20-30% difference I've noticed?
Massive difference.
When I was waiting on you at the subway station, when I was waiting on you at the train station, I went over to a little convenience store. And I just remember things, you know, I would get like a sandwich from the same convenience store over there and it would be like 3 pounds, but here it's like 2.5 or something like that. It's like a little bit cheaper. That's one thing I've noticed.
Yeah.
Need some clothes, 2 pounds.
The price is right there.
Need some African attire. I should get me one of these. Dang, this looks kind of fly, actually. Not my size, though.
But seriously, look at the difference in the price. Oh, yeah.
This is where the locals at, yo.
This is eyebrows, threading, and shops. And the thing is...
Oh, fancy, like, yeah, pushing out. Yeah. Oh, it's going through the gentrification. That's basically what you're trying to say.
So, yuppies.
Oh, yeah, the yuppies. You know, the yuppies are taking over the U.S., too.
Yeah,
I mean, just
every
major city, like, you just... $4,000 a month for rent, $3,000 a month for rent. Yeah. And it's coming here, right? You're saying the same thing.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a world problem. Like, something needs to happen. Yeah, I don't know what can really change it. Everyone wants to move to the city. Young people want to move to the city. All the jobs are in the city. Like, how do you avoid the city? Wow, look at all this. Y'all need some hair?
Get yourself
a wig, right?
No.
I noticed a bunch of these. Super different.
This man is gonna flatten us
like a pancake.
Okay. So.
Wow. Look at this.
What?
2 for 5.
It's a half wig.
It's a half wig. I don't think they're open. They're taking the day off. Look at these colors. Like there's an orange one. Look at those colors,
crazy.
Man, whatever color you need, they got them right here.
Got it right here. Instant transformation. You see, you've even got a nice little, what they call them? Some sort of food pump.
A bun.
You've got a bun on your head.
A bun on your head.
Mind you, 200-400 pounds. They're not bad. So they're good for the, well, you see a lot of women wearing them.
All the time.
Yeah. Oh, see, look at this, Van Milder.
Oh, a new yuppie shop.
Yeah, see, we didn't have none of that. Do you know what I mean? This used to be like little bric-a-brac pound stores and all that, you know?
Inexpensive. Exactly. And now it's like fancy shops
fancy
are moving
shop,
in.
See?
Yeah.
Why do they do that? Do you know what I mean? It's basically, it's not, it's like...
Because all these rich folks need to find more places to take over, right?
Yeah, that's true.
What it really boils down to.
I suppose so.
And they like to pick on certain neighborhoods because they can just get in and get out and get the people out, too.
It's true. It's them type of shops that were there, you know, so... So this is... like shopping. So this is...
Oh wow.
This is actually a typical Brixton day. So
wow, look at this.
Yeah. So the way it's always been about, there's always plenty of wigs around.
Said there's always plenty of wigs around. What's up with the wigs?
People don't have a wig or a weave. One of the two, the wig or a weave. But whatever, but it's good though, it's great.
Wow,
I mean,
look at this. It's some pretty cool stuff here, man.
Yeah.
I like definitely don't need a hoodie or a jacket right now, but if I do, I know where to go.
Very warm.
Very warm. Meow! So on a rainy day, you could totally come here and escape the rain, huh?
Oh, totally, yeah, so.
What's up with this Philip Normal?
Philip Normal.
Is this Philip Normal?
Well, he was normal, but still is, I suppose.
Man, I've seen more vegan places in this neighborhood than I see like anywhere else. Like, everywhere we go is like vegan place, vegan place, vegan place. But once again, those are the places that get gentrified. The vegan places.
Well, vegan seems to be the in thing now anyway, so...
Oh, yeah.
You have to be vegan, so...
Yeah, well, I mean...
I do like a good old steak and chips. So.
Well, you should try some vegan meat. They have vegan steak.
I think definitely I need to try. I mean, there's enough people I know now that are on about vegan. You're one of them.
Yeah, you should be vegan too, man.
You see? There you go. So
You'll live longer.
I need to join the vegan club. So.
You should. It's a great club. It's the best club to be a part of.
So this is, what's his name?
Biggie Smalls.
Smalls. Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out who this is. Maybe if I was standing farther away, I could tell. Or he could be someone from the UK or somewhere.
Yeah, yeah.
I think Biggie and Tupac are like the biggest ones. I don't see Tupac. I may have to stand farther back. I think that's Ice Cube. That looks like Ice Cube for sure.
You know, this is a video log of you vlogging.
That's cool.
Kind of cool. I think this would be kind of cool.
I think that's Tupac. Yeah, there he is. Yeah. Of course, you gotta have Tupac.
He had to be here.
Yeah, you can't. No. You can't talk about hip hop, no, American hip hop, and not have Tupac around, right? Gosh, man, look at some of these prices. Everything's like much, much, much cheaper around here.
Cheaper.
So around here, is there a lot of Nigerians? Is there a lot of Nigerians in this neighborhood?
Everyone, yeah, Nigerians, Africans, and definitely a lot of Jamaicans as well. There'd be a lot of them. A lot of everyone, really.
Jamaicans.
Everyone, and a lot of smelly, stinky fish going on.
Yeah, lots of
smell
fish.
Smell that stuff.
Lots of fish. One thing I did notice about Nigeria, I just kept seeing Nigerian things everywhere, like call Nigeria, Nigerian, Nigeria.
Yeah.
So this is that part of town. Hey, so question, what happened down here? Why is all this stuff boarded up? Did all of that used to be shops, like this block? Like these two blocks over here?
Okay, yes. What you're asking, yeah, it's about the shops that are boarded up. Typical, where you just see all the little pound shops and all that sort of stuff going on.
Oh, you mean these shops?
Yeah, like pound shop, bric-a-brac, music shop selling, you know, vinyl records and CDs and all that used to be along here. And these are sort of like railway arches. Basically, people's livelihood. You know, in their little business and classic gentrification going on. So pretty much
what you're telling me is all of this whole area here,
yeah,
like this whole area, it used to be little shops and little businesses, but now this is about to be something else.
Yeah.
Is it going to be like fancier shops or?
I don't know the exact plans, but all I know is the locals won't be coming back here. They've been moved out somewhere else.
That's pretty much what I was trying to get to. Yeah. The locals will not return after this project's over.
No.
That's a bummer.
Yeah, for real.
We're coming back. Coming back as something new, right?
Yeah.
Something
exactly.
New and fancy.
You know that. Definitely not owned by you, that's for sure. So, yeah.
Definitely not owned by you.
No. Coming back as fancy arches.
So pretty much you got old London here. Look at this old building. Look at this artwork on top of this building. I love this artwork. You can tell this is old because, come on, they don't build buildings like this. Look how the stairwell is outside of the building. Like that's just so old school. But if you want to see something new, here's some new stuff right here. Yeah, there's the new modern stuff right here. But then this is the older stuff. And then we got some gentrification here. 3,000 pounds a month. Then we got the old school history right over here. I'm totally not trying to make this a gentrification video, but it's something like that. These are the newer buses. You say the older buses, you could jump off of the back at red lights or something like that?
Yeah, years ago, you had your Routemaster buses. Then they built these.
With the door.
Yeah, with the door, which is cool. These are all right. But now they've made a new Routemaster to replicate the stuff from ages ago where you could jump off the back.
Oh, so they do have the new buses, they're coming back.
Yeah, basically, but what they've done is...
Oh, check this out.
For real, this is a lovely little skating park.
Got a little skate park here.
Yeah.
Not built for electric skateboards. Wow, this looks pretty fun.
Got saved because there was lovely little social housing around here, and as you can see, that's exactly what was happening to the social housing. So all got destroyed.
So how did this get saved if they're building right next door
because people campaign and say, you know, what are you going to leave for the locals around here, you know? So the thing is, there was enough protests on this This is like the Stockwell Park Skate Park for anyone that's interested. So, yeah, there was enough protests and this sort of stuff. So
it's all about the protests to get things to stop happening.
Yeah.
I'm loving these colors around here. So this is just a random observation I have here. So I see a lot of like beer cans and bottles. So I imagine probably skaters drink. But I also see some wine bottles over there. Skateboarders sipping on wine and skateboarding. Maybe it's a British thing.
There's a bit of a wine over here, is it cooler? So.
Maybe it's a British thing, like yeah. British skaters drinking wine.
It's
what about the Jack Daniels, yo?
You know that for real.
Look at these short buildings. Look how short this is. You can look at that. Like, me next to this building.
Old school.
Well, check it out. It's the memorial for David Bowie, and there's even a couple flowers here. I like how they protected the painting in glass. That's really nice. So this is something San Francisco needs, a toilet guide. Wow, man, what an adventure. What another cool place. I think I'm gonna get ready to take off. But thanks for showing me around once again.
Hey, yeah. You know that, it's always good to see you.
This guy has saved me so many times here in London, yo. Like so many times.
You're my friend.
Yeah, that's awesome,
you
dude.
You know that. So.
That's what's up. Well, take care. Next time I'll be back.
For real.
And, yeah, you'll be in my videos, man.
Hey, definitely. People can check mine out as well.
Yeah. You want to put a link in the description or something?
Put a link on there later.
Look for him in the description below.
Because we've got our behind the scenes of him vlogging around Brixton. That'd be cool.
Yeah, I forgot. We got a little behind the scenes action. But anyway, that's enough for this video. I'm out. Peace out.
Yeah.